welcome to Beer Goggles Perfused with me, Terry Kay. I'm laughing, I don't know why I'm laughing. I just pulled a funny face at the camera. And welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay, and we've got one that a lot of you might not have heard of, unless you're a little bit older, you know, or at least the fella. You might not have heard of the fella unless you're a bit older, but we've got, I don't know if you can see all that, lovely, pretty. When do you start? Oh no, it's 1847. Yeah, that must have been the time he got up. It's a George Gowan Company Limited Summer Breeze Quality English Ale. You got all that? 3.8, it's kind of a light one. A nice necky. Someone was saying something on Saisops there, look. That's usually a lager hop. I've got an idea. This is going to be a little bit like Fuller's Summer Ale. Maybe even the same. I don't know. Because George Gow used to be the... I went all red then. George Gow used to be the head, like the master brewer, the head brewer at Fuller's. Before John Keeling. Sorry, before John Keeling. Did I get the... I weren't watching myself. Did I get the... Did I get the flat in my eyelids? It's a little game I've been having amongst the kind of reviewers, especially like Simon and all that. I keep saying I'm going to do... I'm going to steal his underwear and dry hump his leg and stuff like that. If he ever meets me, he's going to scamper, mate, I'll tell you. No, I just happen to kind of really appreciate the skills of the person and that, and the skills of the man and that. You know, he's one of the few brewing geniuses in the country. There's him, and there's also the guys at Saddlers, you know. They're also, I believe, brewing geniuses. And O'Kells as well. Our doctor, Mike, is it? Mick or Mike? Mike Calbourn. Calbum, I called him, like, as a joke. But I bet that went down well. Where's the BB? Here's the BB. I thought I'd lost it for a minute. Now, crack it open, because we're already... Well, oh, isn't that nice? That's pretty. And the smells that I'm getting off of here is also pretty. As soon as I opened it, they're like, whoosh, straight up. Do you know the funny thing is, though, you get your nose over it and it lost smells. It smells quite lagery. And I would guess that's the Czech hops in it, you know, the kind of sais and things like that. I don't know, maybe Hallertau or something like that. I always say that wrong. It's like millennium and all that, you know. Good, isn't it? What have we got? Just says Saisop. Girl's unique yeast. That smells a bit funny, not skunky or anything, but like someone's had a piss in it. Cool, hold on. Oh, you're getting those right in, you're getting the sherbet-y. Urine? No, you're getting sherbet. Strange. You are getting that Saisop. It's just kind of a light grapefruity sort of lemony sort of thing to it. Look, I'm going to dive in because I ain't getting massive amounts off the nose. There's a tiny bit of a very light kind of one of them Nice biscuits. Nice, does that make any sense to you? They're kind of like a very light flavoured for dipping in tea and whatever else. Dipping in tea, how disgusting. Butterfly smell it. Where'd you come from? Where did they come from? I've looked around all over the place for these little shits. Go on. Where did they actually come from? I don't know what it is with the barflies. Look, here he is. Gotcha. That got ya. Or did it? Sorry, I'm digressing here. Look, where's he gone? I've got him somewhere. He's wearing it like bloody body lotion or something. He'd go dive bombing him. Anyway, let's have a dive in. No swimmers, are they? I don't know what I'm living on, some shit farm or something. Right. That's not bad. It's not bad. It's kind of, there is something I don't like there. There's a kind of metallic thing going on. I'll tell you what I don't like first, and then we'll move on to the other stuff. There's a metallic thing, and there is a kind of slight urine-y sort of taste. I don't know if someone's took a piss in the fuck. Took a whiz in the, in the fermenter or something. But I doubt it, but there's a very, very slight something there, something ammonia-y sort of thing. I've got a hole in my shirt. Nice, isn't it? Just bought this recently. But it's a very, very distant, very delicate little thing going on there. And then you've got kind of like a... You've got like nettles. No, you ain't tasted nettles, have you, you poor suds? But there's kind of like a nettly sort of thing. A bit kind of a... What's a nettle taste like? A little bit like a cross between celery, spinach, and something else, peppery sort of thing. But there's like a pepperiness there. Something's just loaded. A peppering sort of thing. And you've got the saison. So you've got a kind of a lagery feel to it, a lagery kind of taste to it. But you've got a little bit of biscuit in there as well. It's kind of some of the nicer things in there. You've got a light biscuit. There's a very long waiting bitterness that kind of hangs around and then goes, yeah, more, like that. It's not bad. I kind of think that you can get a lot of those flavours, though, out of something like a Foster's or something. So it's kind of, it's not really doing it for me. It's not bad, but it's, I don't think it's as good as the... Pardon me, as the Fuller's Summer Ale, not by a long way. And it's along the similar lines, but it's just it leaves a lot to be desired. Which is a shame. It is a shame because, George Gale's, I don't know if what's happening now, but he used to be a good brewer. and he's kind of got a good name in it. No, I'm not mad about that one. George Gale, Summer Breeze, I would say, don't bother. But when I say these things, they're my opinions. You don't have to take any notice. You don't have to kind of pin a kind of any badge of qualification onto that kind of opinion, because I'm not qualified as a taster or anything like that. Just tasted lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of different beers. So it's, you make your own mind up on what kind of credence you put on that opinion, you know. I personally, I think that, you know, it's worth kind of listening to some people's opinions out there. But what I would personally do, though, is I'd go, okay, that's Terry's opinion. Let's see what Dave thinks of it. You know, have a look at, and search it on the YouTube thing and that, and see who else has done it and see what other people think. And then you kind of get a more informed opinion and more conglomeration of thoughts and that. Look at me, conglomeration. Don't even know what it means. Anyway, as I said, I wouldn't really bother. Right, cutting it short. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you very much for putting up with my inane dribble week after week. And thank you for commenting, all you guys that do comment. It makes it a two-way thing. You know, because, as I said, a person's taste is highly subjective, you know. And what I might think is boring, you might go, what? Like that, you know. What I might think is horrible, you might go, what? You know, it's a very subjective thing. But you kind of, if someone puts a turd in your mouth, you know, you don't need to kind of have qualifications to go, that is disgusting, you know what I mean? So, you know. Anyway, that is a Summer Breeze from George Gale, 3.8%, and it tastes pretty average. Thanks very much. Beer Goggles Reviews. Chin chin. Bye.